Good morning, students. How are you? Perhaps some of you are fine. Today I am going to explain two topics. First one is that factor and multiple, and second one is that prime number and composite number. So one by one I am going to deal these topics. First topic is factor. Students, before explaining the factors, I am going to explain a term that is called divisor. Have you know what is divisor? Divisor is a number who divides, and factor is related to divisor. Factor is the exact divisor of any number. Factor of any number is its exact divisor. It means when we divide by any number and there will be no any remainder, then we say that the number who divides is a factor. Understood, student? Now I am going to write the definition of factor. Factor of any number is its exact divisor. It means when we divide any number by other number and it is exactly divisible, then we say that the number who divides is called factor. For example, I am taking a number, it is 50. Students, first of all, we have to write the smallest factor of this number, which is 1. So we write 1 multiply 50 is equals to 50. Now we think about the second factor of this number, that is 2. So we can write it 2 multiply 25, because 25 is a 50. 3 is not a factor of 50 because 3 cannot divide 50 exactly. Now think about 4. 4 is not exactly divide 50, so 4 is not its factor. Now think about 5. 5 is a factor because 5 tends a 50. Another factor of this number is 10. That is present here. So students, now we write therefore factors of 50 is equals to, you will think about yourself, 1, 2, 5, now 10, 25 and 50. It is all the factors of 50. These are all the factors of 50. 1, 2, 5, 10, 25 and 50 are the factors of 50. Students, you will look here few things. When you write, now we shall take another example. Similarly, factors of 13 is equals to 1 and 30. Student, in both the number you will see 50 has more than 2 factors, but 13 has exactly 2 factors. So we have to conclude few things about the factor. First one is that any number has at least 2 factors. Another thing is that 1 is the smallest factor of any number. Third one is that any number is also a factor. Any number is also the greatest factor, the largest factor of it, of itself. And students, we can count the number of factors of any number. So, fourth point is that number of factors of any number are limited. So, students, it is all about factor. Now I am going to explain multiple. Students, now I am going to explain the second topic, that is multiple. So first of all, we think about this multiplication fact. It is 2 multiply 3 equals to 6. Students, 6 has two factors, 2 and 3. These are the factors of 6. But think, what is 6 for this number? Students, 6 is the multiple of 2 and 3. It means when we find the multiple of any number, we have to multiply it by other pointing number. Okay, students? So, it is the fact that 3 is multiplied by 2, then we get 6. So, 6 is the multiple of 3, as well as 2 is multiplied by 3 and then we get 6. So, 6 is a multiple of 2 also. So, the definition will be multiple of any number is the product of that number. Product of that number with some other counting numbers. Counting numbers such as 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Students, now, by example, I am going to explain this term. For example, when we want to write multiple of any number, we have to multiply that number with 1, 2, 3, 4 and etc. So, multiples of 19. 19 multiplied 1 is equals to 19. It is the first multiple of 19. Another one is that 19 multiplied 2, 38 is the another multiple of 19. 19 multiplied 3, 57. 19 multiplied 4, 76. 19 multiplied 5, 95. This all are multiples of 19. Students, you are thinking that this is the table of 19. Sir is writing the table of 19. It is true, students. Table is a multiple. Table is also a multiple. The first 10 multiple of any number is its table. Okay, students? So now we have to know few things about multiple also. Any number is its smallest multiple. So first point is that any number is its smallest multiple. Second point is that multiples of any number. Multiples of any number are unlimited because countable numbers are unlimited. So, the multiples of any number are unlimited. It is all about multiple. Now, I am going to explain prime number and composite number. Dear students, now we move to the second topic, That is prime number and composite number. Students, I have already discussed about factor, and I have also given you information about factors. Some numbers have minimum two factors, and some numbers have more than two factors. So by this, two numbers are classified. Okay, first one is their prime number. Prime number is the number which has exactly two factors, one and the number itself. And the smallest prime number is 2, because it has two factors, 1 and 2. Another one is 3, another one is 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, etc. These all are prime numbers because they have only two factors, 1 and the number itself. Another one is a composite number. Composite number is the number which has more than two factors. So students, numbers except these numbers are composite number. For example, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 15, 16, etc. These all are composite number because they all have more than two factors. Students, one is not present in the list. Why? Because one has only one factor, that is one. So one is neither prime nor composite. So it is the rule one. One is neither prime nor composite. Another one is that 2 is the smallest prime number. 2 is the smallest and only one even prime number. Students, rest prime numbers are odd. Only 2 is the number, 2 is the prime number which is even. Okay, students? Third point is that 4 is the smallest composite number. 4 is the smallest composite number. Dear students, it is all about today's class. Perhaps you have understood everything. Thank you. Have a nice day.